Make your kitchen ready for every summer gathering this Memorial Day with LG and Lowe's. Our exclusive InstaView appliance suite includes ranges with air fry, refrigerators with slow melting craft ice, and an exclusive dishwasher you can only find at Lowe's. Plus, you'll get up to 10% back via a MasterCard prepaid card when you bundle eligible LG products via rebate. Shop Memorial Day savings at Lowe's. Offer valid 3-3 through 5-18 on select LG items only. See Lowe's.com/rebates for details and timing.
Angie's List is now Angie, your home for everything home. With Angie, you could cross your next project off your to-do list before this ad is over. Just tell us what you need and we'll handle the rest, sending a top pro to get it done. Or browse reviews, compare quotes from pros, and connect instantly, all for free. For everything from routine maintenance to a dream remodel, because however you want your project done, we'll get it done. Download the app or go to Angie.com. That's A-N-G-I.com to get started.
Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at BJGeekNation.com.
Your home is going into foreclosure and you feel like a financial wreck. You don't know where to turn for accurate information. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases, even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. And, yeah, I suppose if you want to buy a T-shirt, that's the dumbest thing ever. Sure. If you've got young children, you want to look them in the eye and go, see this T-shirt? This is why you can't go to college.
Well, then that's just bad financial decisions. If
yeah. Because your daddy did stupid stuff like this his entire life. Listened to Steve Miggs and bought this shirt.
Someone just placed their order on, according to the text line. Just placed my order for the Ride the Turtles T-shirt, BJ. You're welcome. Yeah.
That person probably should be examined to see if, in fact, their brain's still working. I'll tell you.
Ride the Turtle.
So, sure, go to KISW.com and buy one of these Ride the Turtle T-shirts and then wear it all over town so people can identify the morons easier.
If you like making BJ happy, trolling him, buy the shirt and be sure to tag him on his social media pages when you get it.
Yeah.
His daughter will retweet it.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah. KISW.com. Go there and that's one.
Let's play B Migs.
It's time to play the game. So everybody scream his name. B Migs. Don't be a loser.
Beat Migs, and it's time to pump it up for Monday. Hopefully this gets everybody pumped up. BJ, I hope you're pumped up from your weekend of board gaming late into the morning.
I'm ready.
I love it.
I'm almost pumped.
Let's get to our contestant today. We got Jeff and Puyallup. Jeff, are you there?
Yeah, buddies.
All right, Steve, get out of here. For those playing at home, Jeff will have 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. Jeff, you can pass all you want, but you will only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Totally ready.
The energy drink Red Bull was first introduced in what European country?
Germany.
No.
France.
No.
Oh, Italy.
No. The Knicks are an NBA team from where?
New York.
Yes. In the card game Blackjack, what 2 values does the ace have?
1 and 10?
No.
I don't know. Pass.
Peach schnapps and orange juice make up the cocktail fuzzy what?
Maple.
Yes. What is the name of the first lunar module to land on the moon?
Apollo.
No.
Pass.
In what year of the late 2000s did Jersey Shore premiere?
That was 2008, 2009.
No. Yes. What species of poisonous spider has an hourglass pattern on its abdomen?
Black Widow.
Yes. Who is the father of Miley Cyrus?
Billy Ray.
Yes.
Nice.
The Mississippi River flows into what body of water?
Atlantic Ocean.
No.
One, Gulf of Mexico.
Too late. One, two, three, four.
Come on.
Five. Correct. Oh, that might be the deciding factor, but yeah. I think Steve's going to get a lot of those other ones you didn't get, so I'm not going to say you're going to lose, Jeff, but there's a distinct possibility that it's going to happen.
Always. Yep. Always, yes.
Yep. We'll have to see how Steve's sugar buzz is going on there. Yeah. I don't know. How many brownies did you have?
Seven or eight.
Nice.
There you go. I just won the corner piece.
Oh, yeah, that good corner piece.
It's the best piece.
Yeah. It's like that in the heel of the bread. I love the heel.
Oh, hell yeah.
And I don't understand the people who don't.
They're communists, clearly.
Yeah, the communists have never liked the heel or the corner piece of a brownie. It's really...
It's strange how that works. Steve, are you ready?
Ah, yes!
The energy drink Red Bull was first introduced in what European country?
I'm going to go Italy.
No.
France.
No.
Oh, crap. Switzerland.
No.
Sweden?
No. The Knicks are an NBA...
Finland?
No. The Knicks are an NBA team from where?
New York.
Yes. In the card game Blackjack, what two values does the ace have?
11 and 1.
Yes.
11.
Peach
11.
Peach schnapps and orange juice make up the cocktail fuzzy what?
Navel.
Yes. Jeez. What is the name of the first lunar module to land on the moon?
Sputnik.
No.
Apollo.
No.
Challenger.
No. In what year of the late 2000s did Jersey Shore premiere?
2009.
Yes. Oh. What species of poisonous spider has an hourglass pattern on its abdomen?
Tarantula?
No.
Spider.
No.
Charlotte.
No.
Obviously.
Who is the father of Miley Cyrus?
Billy Ray.
Yes.
Don't break my heart.
The Mississippi River flows into what body of water?
The Atlantic Ocean.
No.
The Gulf of Mexico.
Yes! 1, 2, 3, four, five, six. You win!
It's
6-5!
Jeffy!
Because Jeff didn't know Gulf of Mexico in time.
Sorry, Jeff.
The buzzer beater did not happen for me.
Yeah.
Nope.
But thanks for playing, buddy. Try again next time, because I know next time's your time.
And probably. I'm not sure if my wife is still in the car with baby Tatum, but if she is, your father's a winner. Well, you
And right now, your mother's like, yes, he's a real winner, sweetheart.
Your father's a winner, but my husband is a loser.
That's what it is.
You're the man.
They're going to have some great, those two are going to have some great conversations about the genius that is their dad.
Yeah, there'll be a lot of conversations.
There's going to be a lot of SMH moments. I can't wait for the father-daughter, I should say the mother-daughter memes of them with their face palms.
Yeah.
As Steve is being Steve.
There'll be times where I think my wife's going to look at me, look, your father once wrestled.
Yeah.
He's not the brightest.
What do you want?
Just took a couple of chair shots to the head.
Yeah. Didn't have a concussion protocol at the time.
You didn't know the poisonous spider that's got the hourglass pattern.
Come on,
but Jeff did. Black Widow.
Black Widow. I couldn't think of it, man.
Scarlett Johansson.
I know.
She has the belt.
Is that X-Men?
Yeah, that's exactly
what it is.
Killing
me, man.
Yeah, that's exactly.
It's the Avengers, you jerk.
At least he was in the same, at least it's the same comic line.
Oh, well, my bad. Yeah. Justice League, right?
Yeah.
Wonder Twins. She's one of the Wonder Twins.
You're breaking my heart, man.
You're breaking my heart.
The name of the first lunar module that to land on the moon. The Eagle has landed.
Oh,
because nobody was saying anything.
I
was just looking at me.
Deafening science silence in this room.
Yeah. Everyone just stared at me like I just like grew
a corn
or something.
But I knew that I was about to say something, but I knew my answer was wrong. The Eagle has landed. Good call. Jeez, I totally forgot that.
And I figured this one would be a hard one, that the European country that was the first introduction of Red Bull, it's Austria.
Austria.
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
They're the ones that made Red Bull?
Yes, they did.
Someone even said, can we please have Steve keep guessing European countries until he gets it right? I wouldn't have gotten it right. I'll tell you that right now. Spoiler alert. Would have never guessed Austria.
But you're kind of going with the smaller ones like Finland and Switzerland, so I kind of like where you're going with
it. Yeah. That's about as far as it was going
to
go.
If I think Germany, I then go to Austria. It's just like, all right, if it's not Germany, but I think somehow it's got a Bavarian situation, I'm going to go to Austria.
Austria adjacent there.
Yeah. Someone says that the Gulf of Mexico is a sea, which is part of the Atlantic Ocean.
Whatever. Shut up. I don't even like
textures. You heard the man.
I thought Gulf of Mexico is considered its own ocean.
It's its own body of water.
Yeah, okay.
Like they don't call it the Atlantic Coast states. They call it the Gulf Coast states. So
hey, look, I'm just reading what the textures want me to read.
Well, that's interesting because I've never heard that. But then
I literally never heard that.
But doesn't mean it's not true. Did they change it? Like Pluto's now not a planet or a dwarf planet?
Watch out! This guy is like some scientist, some oceanographer or something
that
like
would
that.
Suck.
Like, well, actually,
it's a part of the Gulf of your mother.
Yeah, it's a dwarf sea now. The Gulf of Mexico.
Oh, it is a dwarf sea. Damn it.
Well, congrats, Steve. You won.
Yeah. Well, good job, Steve.
Thank you.
You are a professional.
Damn straight I am.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW. Hey, you got something to say? They're wild, rabid, and on the loose. This is Listeners on the Loose.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. Listeners on the Loose, you pick the topic, you guide the show at 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. If you want to say something, man, you get to say it. But Steve is like, hey, you better do it the right way.
Well, just show some energy and bring it. Otherwise, you're going to be gone. I'm going to have to say goodbye to you.
Goodbye, old friend.
206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. Dan in Seattle, you are on The Rock.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Morning, Dan. Welcome to the show. What you got for us, buddy?
I got a question for you guys. Yesterday, I was at my house, and I was staring at a window that had mini blinds in it that were closed.
All right.
And there was, like, kind of light coming through the slats, and I stared at it for a while, and then I looked away, and everything was, like, super smeared. And I was wondering if you guys have ever done that before.
Ooh.
No, but I've done acid, and I get the same kind of reaction from that.
Oh, that's interesting.
No, I haven't.
Do you guys have mini blinds there at the studio?
No, we got these weird shades.
Yeah,
things.
We don't have mini,
like,
but
like
I have
cloth shades.
I've got blinds at home. I'll have to give that a shot at home. I don't know if it's the mini. Do I need mini blinds, you think, or can I just do regular blinds?
Well, that's what I did. I did mini blinds, but I don't know. It might work for other kinds of blinds, too.
Huh. Because I got girthy blinds. I don't have any.
Girthy blinds. All right, we'll have to check it out. And it makes sense to me. I know that when there's a bright light that gets stuck in my eye, it's there, and it just affects my vision. So imagine, like, these slats of light that's all, and then you turn it around, and then it maybe affects.
Yeah, I try my best not to stare at things. Like, I remember, like, when I was younger, I used to, like, stare at, like, a candle or something, and then, like, your eyes are just jacked for a while.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just like right now, taking a picture with an iPhone, sometimes, man, that light just destroys me.
That bad?
Oh, dude, it kills me. That light. Huh. There's something about those LED, whatever the heck lights that are not amber, but they're sort of bright whitey light. Oh,
yeah.
I can't stand it. I can't stand it on cars. I can't stand it on the phone.
What about on Christmas trees?
Christmas trees, I have a hard time with it, so I like to get the colored lights, at least.
Oh, so I like those LED lights for Christmas. I like how bright they look.
Yeah, the bright, the one color, white. The bright, white, everything else is fine.
I was actually really mad because I bought a new truck last year, and it turns out that the LED white lights weren't put on until the year after 2020.
Oh.
And so I was like, I want the really bright ones because I think I can see better with them, like just going out, but I still have the amber ones.
The trouble is I don't know if anybody else has the same problem I do. They destroy me in my rearview mirror. Though it's just, and it's not the amber. Even the new ambers I don't have a problem with. So I don't know. Maybe you're right, Danny. Maybe people do see better, but it wrecks me. And I was like, I got to find a way to tilt my windows and everything. Just my
mirrors.
Do
you have the thing on your rearview that you flip that will turn it like don't?
Yeah, I've got
it?
That. Okay. But then I've got to also just basically move my rear my side mirrors because I can see it inside and it wrecks me.
There are some headlights where I'm just like, dude, take your high beams off, and then you realize those aren't high beams; they're just like really strong headlights.
Notice the color. See if it's just the white ones, because I don't have a problem with the ambers.
Yeah, it's definitely the white ones, because it's how bright it is.
So I'm like wondering if anybody else has a problem, and even though, I feel like I've been able to see for the rest of my whole life driving, the ambers have been fine.
Mm-hmm.
But if it's wrecking people on the other side of it, I wonder why they're putting them on maybe it's just you and me.
That's the new way to go, though. I know that like all of the new models have them.
And they don't bother you, Danny, in the rear view?
No, not at all.
See, I got issues.
Well, I mean, we would have told you that before you even brought up this whole conversation.
Thanks, buddy.
Someone said, now that Danny's back, I have a question for Danny.
Ooh.
When are you going to be skateboarding in Britain? No, it's not that. he said he was going to do a bottle of scotch in a time capsule a while back. My grandson was just born. I'd like to hold a bottle of scotch until he turns 21. Which scotch would you recommend?
Ooh, good call.
That is a good question. I'm not a huge scotch drinker. I more do rye whiskeys. Mm-hmm. But lately I've been really going with just the Johnny Walker Double Black. I love Johnny Walker scotches just in general, but the Double Black, for some reason, just has a really nice smoke to it. And that's what I'd go to. And it's not overly priced either.
Like the Johnny Walker Blue Label?
No, that one's...
That's fancy SS.
Yeah, that's like $250 or something. Ooh. The Double Black, you can get a nice bottle for like $80. And right. That's something that would be a fun thing to just like open up at a time capsule.
What would it be though? A $250 bottle, a dollar bottle of scotch. What do you think it would be worth in 21 years?
That's true.
I mean, he may want to drink it, or he may just want to sell it.
Have you ever had the Johnny Walker Blue Label?
I have at one of Joey's friends' house, and I was kind of inebriated when I drank it, so I don't really remember what it
tasted
like.
Not cool.
When my uncle was still alive, he's no longer with us, but he was a big fan. And my uncle, they were doing very well. Like, they lived very, very extravagant lifestyle. They had good money in their life. But he was big fan of the Blue Label, and finally I was like, he kept trying to get me to try it, and I was never a scotch guy. And he's like, just try it. And I tried it. I'm like, all right, yeah, that's really freaking good.
Is it smooth, Steve? Is that what the difference is?
It just tasted really good. We're talking over 10 years ago, so I can't really remember exactly how good it was. But I remember saying to him, like, okay, this is not the scotch that I've had in my life that's made me sick to my stomach.
Oh, because okay.
I was living the college cheap ass life where you get the bottom shelf scotch, and you're like, ugh, this is terrible,
right?
It's just like tequila. For the longest time, I thought tequila was nasty, and then I realized, no, good tequila is actually really good.
It doesn't even taste like tequila, from what I've heard. Yeah. Yeah, I really enjoy it. If you don't want to do scotch, like, I would definitely look at some like local distilleries that they just do regular like rye whiskey or American whiskey, like Copperworks Distilling. That's literally my favorite distillery in Seattle.
Okay.
And they do like limited edition ones. So if you wanted to put something like that in a time capsule, I think that'd be really special.
A few people have been saying go with the Macallan 12.
Oh,
it's 12 years old.
That's right.
Or you could just go online. I just did a Blue Label search, and if you get the Johnny Walker Blue Label 200th Anniversary Blended Scotch Whiskey, like, little pack, it's only $3,500.
Oh, it's not terrible.
Yeah, he's worth it, though. He's your kid.
If you love him, you'll get it. I'll send you the link, sir.
Boy, that does look fancy.
Yeah.
It surely does.
Oh, so this is at Karma, my favorite Indian food place. They sell Johnny Walker Blue shots for $65 a shot.
Woo! Yeah, that's a lot of shot.
That's a lot of money. I don't think I could do that.
Yeah. I got to get to Karma one of these years.
I think I'll just stick with Fireball.
Nice. Oh, yeah. 21-year-old Fireball will be delicious.
Yeah. Yeah, it will.
Also, we should just go get the Blue Label shots once we win the lottery.
Or we just get a empty bottle of it, hit up like somewhere, like, hey, bud, and then we could fill it up with our own scotch.
That's the way to do it.
There's actually one here in the station, an empty bottle.
Okay.
There you go. Just fill it up with like some other rando scotch and be like, dude, sometimes it's the placebo effect. Like, one of my buddies, I remember that Super Bowl party that you came over when the Seahawks won the Super Bowl. One of the guys showed up with a bottle of Patron. I'm like, dude, look at you, mister. And he's like, actually, it's not really Patron. It's just I had this empty bottle, and I filled it with like some like Kirkland brand. And one of the guys on our team was like, I love Patron. I've never had it before. And he was drinking it the whole night thinking it was the greatest thing ever. And all of us was like, he has no idea.
That's awesome.
Kirkland makes some damn good tequila.
Yeah.
Right?
I don't know if it was Kirkland, but it was like, like some random generic brand. It wasn't Patron.
I stand by Kirkland, though. I mean, really. If you're going to have to get a not a fancy brand name, Kirkland's a good brand. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999.
Somebody want to know, is there a show that you watch with your significant other that you would never watch on your own, but you tolerate it? For me, it's 911. Oh, see, 911's a badass show. We even watched 911 Austin, the spinoff.
Wow.
Spinoffs?
Hello.
Yeah.
Wow. Look at this. And this person would never watch it without their cigo.
I probably wouldn't have either, though. It's like one of those ones where I'm like, let's just give it a shot. It sounds like something that both of us will see eye to eye on. And then once we started watching it, we both fell in love with it.
Yeah. I would guess, the last one I could remember that I wouldn't watch, I don't think, if she wasn't interested, would be Downton Abbey.
Ugh.
Yeah. But it turned out to be it turned out to be a much better show than I thought it would be. And I really ended up enjoying it. But there is no way I would have watched that on my own.
I'm glad my wife has never thought of even wanting to bring that one up in our household. I'm sure it's fine. It's just not. It's not in my wheelhouse.
No, it's not. It's a well done show.
Right. And exactly.
But
not
it's
my
still,
wheelhouse.
Yeah. But there's a lot of you've told me about things that I know are good shows. Like, well, for instance, I know Cobra Kai is a good show. I've even watched a couple of episodes. Mm-hmm. No interest in it whatsoever. Now, if Kathy was, then maybe I'd watch it. But she hasn't.
Too bad. Rev, have you finished it?
Yeah, we finally did finish it, and you know what? It's fun.
and I'm glad to see where it's going to go. I just hope it's only going to have four seasons.
Yeah, I think one more season's enough for Cobra Kai.
It needs to end next season.
But can we all agree that the true miracle worker in life is Dee Snider of Twisted Sister?
No, yes.
Leave it at that.
Spoiler alert. Is that a spoiler
alert? No spoilers.
Alert?
I won't spoil it.
There were no spoilers there.
No.
Well, except that, you know, I don't remember him being at all in the series in the first couple episodes I watched.
Well, it's not like it's. Trust me, it's not a spoiler.
Okay, it's not a spoiler.
Fair enough.
Just Dee Snider.
All right, so Vicky, how about you? What's
I don't have a significant other, but thank you for reminding me.
Okay, well that's sad now, Steve.
I'm kidding.
Steve, that's really sad. All right.
Oh, I can't make fun
Vicky,
of myself.
So when you're alone,
pretending to have a boyfriend,
what do you watch? I'm thinking
you don't
that your pretend boyfriend would like it.
Whoa!
I don't want to know. We know you watch porn. They watch it whether you have a boyfriend or not.
No, but I think the closest I have to this, and it's funny because I actually am tempted to watch the show when I'm by myself, is when I'm hanging out with my foster brother, Prince Migs. I really like the show Tots, which is a Disney children's show, like baby show.
That does count.
So I'll play it and he'll leave the room and I'll continue to watch it for hours.
Oh, okay. That's a little disturbing, but okay.
I can't knock you though. Like, I just got excited to see that Trolls World Tour or whatever that one is. It's on Netflix, all the seasons. And I'm like, cool. Not going to miss any of the episodes.
Are you watching it by yourself yet?
Not yet.
Okay.
But emphasis on yet.
Yeah.
Yeah. I won't mess with, we watch Mighty Mike. That's another good one. Which I feel like is a current version of Tom and Jerry. It just seems the same thing. It's like a bunch of people, just chaos ensues with animals, and there's no talking.
Well, you know what? I mean, let's be honest. When you're on this planet long enough, you start to see themes repeat.
Yeah.
You know? So that makes a lot of sense. And yeah, Steve, you, Vicky, Danny, you all know that it's not just your significant other anymore. There are shows you watch with your kids that no way would you watch on your own.
The show that I end up watching now with my wife, that it's her show, but like when it's on, I don't tell her. Like usually, like when one of us comes home, it's like if I'm watching wrestling, I'm like, okay, what do you want to watch? And she does this with this one. And I'm like, it's fine, keep it on. It's not my favorite show, but I'll tolerate it. It's that Below Deck reality show.
Oh, Sarah
loves
that
about it.
Yeah,
that show's crazy.
My wife loves that show
because it's just chaos on the water.
Yeah,
with like all these rich entitled jerks.
Yeah,
and the captain of the ship is just like he doesn't take any. Captain of the ship.
Yeah, he doesn't take any ship on the ship.
That guy, I love that guy because he's just cursing them out and gets all pissed off.
Well, that's great.
And he's got like hot coworkers. Everything about it's pretty awesome.
Yeah, you know, and I wanted to get into it. I really did because Kathy likes a lot of those reality shows and I actually go, you know what, I'm going to go do something else. That's the one I draw the line on any of those reality shows. Outside of like a Survivor or a competition show, I just can't do it.
Mm-hmm.
Just can't do it. And I think another show is Alone. That I don't think I would watch any of it. I wouldn't watch that show, which is basically people trying to survive in the wilderness by themselves and outlast each other by just who's the last one to say, I'm going to go home. And I would never watch that without her. And then we went through all six seasons. We haven't done the seventh yet.
So it's a Zoe's Extraordinary Playlist. My wife got me watching that. That's funny because I remember it's a sitcom. I can't remember. I think it's on NBC. I can't remember, but it's
kind of a
quirky sitcom. I remember seeing like trailers for it. I'm like, I don't know if my wife would dig that one. So I was like, I'll probably never watch it. I came home one day. I'm like, oh, she's watching it. And she's pretty much done with it. So I'm like, oh, I guess I'm not watching this one.
Oh, that sucks. I hate that.
But when are we going to tell her not to watch something? She'd stay at home. I mean, so like, you know.
Yeah, you do. You're the man of the house. You tell her. We have shows together.
Okay, yeah. I'm really going to get that upset about a television
show. You go, we have shows. Dude, I'll tell you.
Dare you when Tatum's taking a nap, watch something that I would have watched.
Do you want to watch crap or do you want to make sure the show's
Yes, I watch wrestling. I like watching crap, BJ.
No, but that's crap you like. You don't want to watch crap that she likes. You want to watch crap you both like. I'm telling you, guys, you say what you want, but I mean, I get mad at Kathy. Go, look, we have to find shows that we love together, so you need to not watch something that I'm tolerant of, and I will do the same for you. I will not watch a show without you if you're tolerant of it.
So would Steve have watched Grey's Anatomy on his own? Absolutely not.
Oh, God, no.
And then we've kind of, luckily, we're done with that one.
It's got like, what, 90 seasons? I mean, they really, everybody should be dead by now with their anatomy.
You know what it took, though? Them wearing masks. Like, all of a sudden we put on an episode, and it was just like the entire episode was all of them were wearing. And my wife's just like, we got to deal with the mask crap everywhere else we go. Like, can we not have it on our television shows? Like, you know what I mean? Like, can we get a break from mask life? And I was like, you're right. We shouldn't watch this. And we haven't watched another episode.
Look at you. Look at you just looking for the parachute. Okay.
Well, dude, we've been holding on hope for a show that just should have been like, you know, they should have taken it out back and put it out of its misery like two seasons ago.
You're absolutely right.
Yeah.
That's, I think that's what, 15 seasons has it had? I mean, it's just nuts.
The last couple have just been like unnecessary.
Now I think they're going for the marathon, like maybe the longest live action primetime show. I think they might be going for that now.
Or just the paycheck.
And well, who doesn't want that?
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
Kickstart summer at Lowe's with Memorial Day savings on major appliances like the Smart Whirlpool Top Load Washer featuring the 2-in-1 removable agitator in a color you'll only find at Lowe's. Take it out for bulky items, leave it in for a more thorough clean. You can customize any load, plus skip steps with the Load and Go dispenser. Simply add detergent once and skip the refills. Memorial Day savings start now at Lowe's. Shop in-store or online today.
Angie's List is now Angie, your home for everything home. With Angie, you could cross your next project off your to-do list before this ad is over. Just tell us what you need and we'll handle the rest, sending a top pro to get it done. Or browse reviews, compare quotes from pros, and connect instantly, all for free. For everything from routine maintenance to a dream remodel. Because however you want your project done, we'll get it done. Download the app or go to Angie.com. That's A-N-G-I.com to get started.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. It's listeners on the loose. You pick the topic, you guide the show. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999.
Oh, someone needs some help. Sounds like a very serious issue.
Well, I'm here for being serious, and I have issues.
All right, says, guys, I seriously need some help. My wife and I are in our mid-20s and are just now getting into superhero films.
Nice.
Oh, damn. We just watched all the X-Men movies and loved them. And we watched two Fantastic Four movies and they were utter garbage. We need some recommendations for good superhero movies to watch.
I wonder which two Fantastic Four movies they watch. If they watch the ones, you know.
How many are there?
There's three.
Okay.
Yeah, so I don't know
Well, technically four.
Yeah, but nobody got to see Corman.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
but I think it's out there.
I think we all agree that they should watch the Ang Lee Hulk movie if they want to see a great comic book film.
No.
Yeah, that
I'm
was,
kidding.
That
you
was,
don't want to put yourself. Unless you like artsy-fartsy stuff, you're not going to enjoy it.
Yeah, that was out there.
What would you say if you had only one comic book movie to recommend? Which one would it be?
Just well, one?
And just one.
And, well, they've already liked the X-Men. That's the problem.
Right. Mm.
But I think that really the way Marvel did it was the right way. The first big one that they gave us, you know, from the MCU, I'm not talking Spider-Man, I'm talking Iron Man. I think that was a really good gateway movie. It was the first one of the MCU.
Yeah, I would probably say that and then see if you guys want to keep going along with all of the rest of their movies. I mean, there's only like, 23 or so?
That's all.
Yeah, so you can start down that journey if you want to be a little less. I would even just say the Spider-Man movies. Like even the early Sam Raimi ones, or at least the first two.
Dude, I was going to say, well, I don't know what the names are. Obvious, but the whatever the one with Tom Holland as Spider-Man, the first one.
Oh, that's not what he's talking about, but yeah.
What's the name of that
one?
The Far From Home?
Far From Nuken. It was a great
Oh, no, Homecoming, then Far From Home. Yeah.
Homecoming might be one of my favorite comic book movies. I might put that at the top of my list.
Good call. It's a good
movie. I really enjoyed that one.
You know what, Revan, that's a good question. And do you start somebody on that Spider-Man, or do you have him go back to the Tobey Maguire first Sam Raimi one?
It doesn't suck.
But it's 20 years old almost. I mean, it really is kind of, I mean, it might be a little too dated.
Yeah, maybe. It might be a little too dated. But they're not little kids watching this. So I think that they can be like kind of cool with maybe antiquated graphics.
Yeah. It's a tough call. I don't think you'll be disappointed with Iron Man because Robert Downey Jr. just does such a great job as the character. He's much more charming and funny than really Tom Holland is and all of that. So, but then again, they've already watched. They said they loved all the X-Men movies, which means that's hard for me to believe.
I've lost. Honestly, I don't watch any more of them because I don't know which ones I've seen and which ones I haven't. Yeah. It's like it's just too many.
And I'm curious. Yeah. Are they talking about like the first like three or so they came out with plus like the origin movies and or the newer three or four, however many there are?
We're getting in the weeds,
or
girl.
All of them. Exactly.
It's hard to know. We're getting in the weeds.
I'd say we all agree Iron Man and Green Lantern. Those should be the two
those
movies.
Are the ones.
Steve. Daredevil.
Yeah.
What?
Man, you are.
Iron Man, Green Lantern, Daredevil. I think you got it right there. Perfect. And the Punisher, the Dolph Lundgren one.
Actually, I like that one.
Thank you.
Yeah.
How about Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle Secret of the Ooze? That's
that
the
is
best
not
one ever.
Why would you even go with the first one?
Because the first one's terrible. The second one is
Wait,
way
Secret
better.
Of the Ooze with Go fight. Ninja Go with Vanilla Ice?
Yes.
Okay, you're amazing.
He's right.
And they fight. Are superheroes.
You are
Aquaman?
Slightly high.
What about Aquaman? That was
okay,
a good
you're
one.
Just, you are just being a douche. Okay.
No, I'm telling
you. No, you are. You're picking up all the
Wonder
worst
Woman
movies.
1984.
Being that's the one. One. Good Start one. With that one, and then you'll stop altogether.
Black Panther. That'd be a good one.
That actually is a good one as well.
That's a great movie.
It is a good one, but I argue that I think you've got to be launched into the MCU. Well, I don't know. Black Panther could stand on its own.
It's a total standalone.
Yeah, I think you're right about
Thor
that.
Thor Ragnarok could actually kind of do that as well.
Sure, right. Yeah, and that's a funny movie.
That's a great movie, and it's got really, really awesome characters and a really fun way to see the Hulk.
Black Panther's a great movie, but I feel like you need humor, and Black Panther doesn't have as much humor as the first Iron Man or as Thor Ragnarok.
Even Guardians of the Galaxy.
That's another good one.
So I can't argue with that
one
either.
A lot of texts are coming in for Deadpool.
See, that was what I was going to say. Either Deadpool.
They're adults, yeah.
Or Logan.
They're adults.
I feel like.
Logan's awesome.
It's amazing, but it's very different.
Here's the thing that I would love you to do. Because Deadpool's good. I feel like watch a couple of Marvel movies, then Deadpool, because you'll really appreciate it for some reason.
That's a good call.
Because it's a parody.
Yeah.
Then watch a movie called Mystery Men. If you have not watched Mystery Men and you've watched all these superhero movies, the movie was made well before its time. It should have been made now because it's really, really funny, but it parodied a genre that nobody really cared about or was seeing a lot of. But now I think Mystery Men is really funny. It's a goofy parody superhero movie. It's got Dane Cook, William H. Macy. It's got Hank Azaria from The Simpsons. And it's got Ben Stiller. So good. It's so good, but nobody cared about comics or superheroes when it came out, really, the way they do now.
What about all the Christian Bale Batman movies?
Oh, yeah, those are superhero movies.
They're total superhero
movies.
I don't consider
those superhero movies.
I know. Yeah, but they are.
I know.
He's a superhero as Falcon.
I mean, they're not lighthearted. Definitely. If you're looking to be more lighthearted, then maybe stay away from them. But if you really want to get in on it.
Yeah, you get to see.
Those are good movies.
You get to see Liam Neeson's Taken character a little bit younger.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you're right. it depends on what you're in the mood for. But if you're a Marvel person, that's why you don't think of DC, which is Batman. So that's the thing.
Well, at least we got to the bottom of it all.
Did we, though?
Howard
we just talked about a lot of movies.
Yeah, we did.
So start with Green Lantern.
Don't start with Green Lantern.
Then Ang Lee's the Hulk.
Oh, dude, stop.
But here's the thing. You've got to watch Green Lantern if you're going to appreciate the post-credit scene in Deadpool 1.
Dude, no one needs to watch a full movie just to appreciate a little scene in post-credits.
I have never seen the Green Lantern movie, and I'm okay with this.
All right,
good
fair enough.
Yeah.
But see, I think I've lived it. I suffered through it.
I lived it.
It made that post-credit scene so much more rewarding that, you know, because of my pain. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. It's Listeners on the Loose.
Somebody said, hey, in reference to this morning's topic this is from the whole, like, crazy things you found about your family. Someone said, I found out that my granddad was Bobby Hatfield from the Righteous Brothers.
Oh, whoa.
My mom has a book published and is selling it on Amazon about her entire journey through life. It's pretty cool. I, myself, have zero musical talent, but my brother, on the other hand, he can sing and he rocks out on the guitar with the best of them. So rock on. Much love and support. My dad, the book is called My Birth Dad Was a Righteous Brother by Sherry Strobaugh.
So her mom didn't know, but recently, I guess, found out at some point
she was
in her
adopted,
life.
Yeah.
Oh, that's trippy. Again, there's, you know, man, you could have had some cash. Like that woman that found out her dad's a billionaire. And he wants nothing to do with her. And she just, I mean, like, I would be hitting hard for that money.
Someone thought, hey, speaking of movies, did you hear that they're going to be bringing back Willy Wonka for a prequel? I am excited.
Well, it depends on what you thought of the last movie with Tim Burton and Johnny Depp.
Never watched it.
Yeah. I mean, there's something. I was just raised on Gene Wilder's original 60s Willy Wonka. So I thought Johnny Depp did a good job, and I thought it was an interesting take. And people say it was closer to what the mood of the book was. So it's interesting to see what Warner Brothers will do with this Charlie and the Chocolate Factory prequel, which is just going to be called Wonka. It's been in development for years, but they've just said, okay, we'll start it up again. We'll do it. And they hope to release it. Don't worry. We just have a little time to wait. The March of 2023. So there you go. Just wait to
2023.
Yeah.
The hell's going to take them that long?
There's a thing called COVID.
Yeah. Other places are making things happen.
Well, you know what? Here we are just going,
just talk
easy.
To Tom Cruise. He's got robots to handle all that.
Yeah, he does.
So it's just going to be called Wonka?
It's going to be, and it's a prequel. So we'll see how he got started doing his factory and why he got to be the king of chocolate. And
they're saying
all this.
Tom Holland, oddly enough, Spider-Man we just talked about, he might be playing the role of young Wonka.
Oh, really?
Yeah. or Timothy Chalamet.
Chalamet.
Oh, how do I know that name?
He's going to be in the new Dune.
I don't know. He looks like Edward Scissorhands.
Oh, yeah, he does. He should be Edward Scissorhands.
Is he Paul Atreides? Is that who he is in Dune?
Yeah.
Oh, the main character? Okay.
Yeah.
Alrighty. He's the one that everyone talks about being Reed Richards' son in a future movie, possibly.
Reed Richards' son in a future movie. Mm-hmm. But we got this kid everywhere, and he hasn't even started in Dune yet. Let me see him in Dune first before I put him in anything else.
Right? Yeah,
that's a good
Come
one.
On.
No, he could be Wonka.
He could be Wonka. Well, who loves Wonka here? Anybody?
I mean, I love the Gene Wilder one.
See, I love the Charlie one. Or the Johnny Depp one.
I just can't. Honestly, I should watch it. I have no issue with anybody involved with it. Tim Burton, I don't love Johnny Depp, but I don't hate the guy.
Sure.
I should watch it, but I for some reason, do not want to watch it because I just love the original so much. I just feel like you can never come to that level.
Yeah, and I think I'm on the side of I love Tim Burton so much, and it was just such a weird movie. And whereas, like, the Gene Wilder one, when I watched it when I was a kid, that one gave me nightmares. Like the boat scene and
the boat scene's really intense.
It was just one of those, like, it really got me. Like, so I never liked that movie growing up, but then being a fan of Tim Burton and seeing that version, I was like, oh, this is more my speed.
Which is so bizarre because the tone and the mood of the new movie seems to be much more frightening, if you will, but I see what you're saying, Danny. It frightened a lot of kids, the Gene Wilder one.
Yeah.
And it was such a great movie for its time, no doubt about it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, that's it. Well, March of 2023, we'll see what happens. We'll see what we think of Timothy Chalamet or Tom Holland, whoever gets the job.
Fair.
Yeah. We don't know who's getting the job yet. Yeah, I guess before – that's why it's taken so long, Steve. They haven't figured out who's going to be in the movie.
Yeah, solid point.
Yeah, you know.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. Here's another question from a listener. Can I leave things off of a bankruptcy, like my car?
You have to list all of your assets and creditors when you file bankruptcy. So you would have to tell the court and the trustee that you have the car or that you have a car loan. You could say that I want to keep my car and continue to make my payments on the car. But the court will need to know that you have a car and that you may have a payment on the car. So by leaving it off the bankruptcy, if you mean that you cannot disclose it to the court, the answer to that is no, you must disclose it. However, that does not mean that you'll lose those assets. You'll be able to keep things like a car and a house in almost all cases, but you must disclose them to the court. But you'll need to continue to make payments on a house or a car that you intend to keep.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.
Make your kitchen ready for every summer gathering this Memorial Day with LG and Lowe's. Our exclusive InstaView appliance suite includes ranges with air fry, refrigerators with slow melting Kraft ice, and an exclusive dishwasher you can only find at Lowe's. Plus, you'll get up to 10% back via a MasterCard prepaid card when you bundle eligible LG products via rebate. Shop Memorial Day savings at Lowe's. Offer valid 3/3 through 5/18 on select LG items only. See Lowe's.com/rebates for details and timing.